Hello, welcome back everyone. This is Caleb from Caleb's Video Maker 2. This is your fifth video inside of your database clustering series. Now, we are actually going to start setting up our database cluster. And as I mentioned in previous videos, we are going to be using virtual machines and then connecting those guys. So each virtual machine is going to be one of our nodes in our database cluster. So to work with virtual machines, there's an application out there called VirtualBox, where this just allows you to kind of install a computer inside of a computer. So to download this application, you can click this downloads button on the left and then figure out what operating system you're running. So I'm running OS X, so that's the one I would use. Once you got that downloaded, you can install it. It's really simple. I'm not gonna waste your time guiding you through that process, but it'll look something like this. Voila, now you can see I have a bunch of stuff already installed. Don't worry about that. That's what I've used to prepare for this video series, and I just want to keep that just in case I need to go back and reference it. But what's most important is what we are going to be creating. So we're actually going to be creating three virtual machines. The great part is, though, you don't have to go through the entire process of setting up a machine three times. With VirtualBox, you can actually just create one, and then you can just make a clone into the second one and the third one. You'll just want to change the MAC address, which I'll show you how to do all of that. To install our first virtual machine, we are going to need an operating system. You can download an operating system in a file, and it'll be of the type .iso. The operating system that I'm going to use is called Ubuntu, and you can download that on the Ubuntu website, ubuntu.com, and this link is /download/desktop. Now, if you are working on the series for a production environment and you have a particular clustering software that you're going to be using, you will want to make sure that that software is available on whatever particular operating system you are going to be using. For example, the Oracle Galera cluster is currently not offered on odd versions of Ubuntu. So it should work on this one. And if I scroll down, you'll see 17. I don't think it's going to work on that one. So we are going to go with the 16 and just click download. And no, I don't want to donate, gosh. And there you go, it'll start downloading. Give that about 4 days, it'll finally finish, and then you can start working on building the virtual machines. Back here in VirtualBox, after you have that finished downloading, you can click this new button. I'll just give this a creative name. And essentially, we want to make an operating system that we can continually clone. So this is kind of like the blueprint for the rest of the operating systems. So if you want to expand your cluster to... Claire, come on, seriously? Well, as I was saying before I was rudely interrupted by that freak, this is going to be the blueprint for the rest of our operating systems. So you want to give it a general name such as... Starter. Now you can select your operating system. We're using a type of Linux, specifically Ubuntu, then click Continue. Now, how much memory do you want to allocate? This is pretty important. I'm going to give it a lot more. So I'm gonna go with 4096. Continue. Yes, we wanna create a virtual hard disk now. So for this part, I'm going to click dynamically allocated. And this is talking about the hard disk for the virtual machine. So I want to pick dynamically allocated because the virtual machine is only going to take up as much space as it needs. And that way I can save space on my laptop. So when you click continue, this is going to ask you the size of the virtual machine disk. This page has given me problems before because I have a bad habit of not really reading directions. I probably shouldn't tell that to the entire YouTube audience, but this is the max size. This is not the size that you start with. So if you want to cap out the size at 8 gigabytes, you would leave 8. But that is not nearly enough space. So I'm going to go in here and put 50. But the thing is, it's not actually going to take 50 gigabytes. It might only take, you know, 10 gigabytes or 15 or 40. But this allows me to expand up to 50 gigabytes if I need. Now click create. All right, and it'll appear down here on this list. I'm actually just gonna take it and drag it all the way up to the top. So when we have this here, we can click start. And what this is going to do is ask you to give that ISO that you downloaded. So just click this little folder here and now find that file. Click it and click open and then start. This is going to begin the setup for the virtual machine and this is where my computer starts growling with the fans. So if you hear a, that's what that is. When that's done loading, it's going to ask you whether you want to try or install. Obviously, we're going to want to install so we can use it more than once. Yes, we are going to download updates. Continue. Yes, erase disk and install Ubuntu is fine. That's specifically talking about the virtual disk that we created when we created this virtual machine. So this does not have access to your hard drive. It's not going to delete everything. And you can go through the rest of the installation process. It's really not too complicated. Now here you're going to want to fill out some information, and I'm going to give a really secure password. Continue. Once that's finally done, you're going to click restart. And at this screen where it says please remove the installation medium, you can just press enter. And there you go. The Ubuntu desktop is now set up. Oh yeah. Yeah, what's up? So I would say that's probably enough information for one video. In the next video, I'm going to be talking about how to install everything we need to install to do SSH and how to clone these desktops. It's going to be great, so make sure you check out the next video. Thank you guys for watching so much. I really appreciate it. And if you don't mind, just do me a favor and click the subscribe button. That will tell me that, hey, this person likes my content, and that'll encourage me to make more stuff. So thank you for everything, and I'll see you in the next video.